Hello, my name is Michel Birler, and in this small video I will show you how to estimate a simple model with PandasBiogeme. I will be using a dataset called Swiss Metro, and you will find it on the webpage of Biogeme, as well as information and documentation about this dataset. This video has been produced using Biogeme version 3.6. If you are using a more recent version of Biogeme, it may happen that there will be some small differences, but globally speaking, the syntax should stay stable for a while. I have created a new notebook that I will call my first model. And now I will specify the model step by step and estimate its parameters. The first step consists in importing the Python packages. First, I import Panda, which is the library that will manage the data. Then I import several modules from Biogeme, the database, the Biogeme itself, the models, and also the version. And finally, I extract an expression that will be used for Biogeme that is called beta, that we will see in a while. The first thing I do is to check the version of Biogeme. By using the getVersion function of the version module. The version of Biogeme that I'm running here is 3.2.6. So if you use a more recent version, there may be slight differences with what we will see in this video, but the global syntax will be the same. Step two is that we will need to prepare the data. First, we read the data from the data file. We will use the Swiss Metro example that is available on the Biogeme webpage. And we use the read CSV function of Panda to read the data file. We specify that the columns are separated by tabs, which is the character backslash T here. And then we display the content of DF, which is the data frame where the data has been stored. So the Jupyter notebook gives you a subset of this data frame. You can also get some statistic if you type df.describe. For each of the column, it will give you the number, the mean, the standard error, the min, and the quantiles, and so on. So you can have a look at the data directly from Panda. Now we need to prepare this data for Biogeme, and to do this, we will use the module of Biogeme called database that we have abbreviated with DB. So we create a Biogeme database that is called Swiss Metro by using the data frame that has been imported from Panda. Now it will be convenient to use the names of the variables in the data file directly as Python variables. In order to be able to do so, we need to provide a specific statement. Basically, we update the list of global variables available from Python, and we extend this by the list of variables which are in the database. We continue preparing the data by removing some of the observations available in the file. First, let's see how many observations are available now. And now I want to exclude some of these observations. I want to exclude those for which the trip purpose is different from one. And the trip purpose is different from three. Or the choice is equal to zero. And if this expression is strictly greater than zero, I exclude the observation. So some comments about this syntax. Biogeme is considering Boolean values as 0 and 1s. Okay, so if purpose is different from 1, the value of this quantity will be 1. If not, it will be 0. Same thing for purpose different from 3, so it will be 0 or 1. And then the product of the two will be 1 only if both are equal to 1. So it acts like an AND. And here, if choice is equal to 0, which actually does not correspond to any valid alternative, this will be 1, and this will be added to the quantity that has been calculated before. So irrespectively of the value of that quantity, the value of exclude will be greater than 0 if choice is equal to 0. So the plus is acting like an OR. And we tell the database object to remove all the observations that correspond to this condition. Now if we calculate the new sample size after having removed these observations, we are reaching a total of 6,768 observations. Okay, so now the data are prepared, we are ready to specify the model. First, we need to specify the list of parameters to be estimated. In this example, we have 5 parameters to be estimated, and you see here that we are using the function beta that we have imported in the beginning. So beta is a specific function from Biogeme that defines a parameter to be estimated. It accepts 5 parameters. The first one is the name that will be used in the reporting of Biogeme. I strongly advise you to use exactly the same name for the Python variable that will be used later on in the utility function. The second parameter is the default value that will be used as a starting point for the estimation. If you don't know what to put, put 0. The next two parameters are the lower bound and upper bound that you want to set on the parameter. If you don't want to set any bound, you write none instead, like in this example. And the last parameter is a parameter that can take the value 0 or 1. If it is 0, the parameter will be estimated from data. If it is 1, like in this example for the ASCSM, Biogeme will not modify the value. It will use the value that you have decided here and keep it to that value during the estimation. It will not modify it. We can define new variables as well. So for example, here I will define a total of 10 new variables. The first two variables redefine the cost of the public transportation alternative, the Swiss Metro and the train. The reason is that if people possess a general abonnement, which is a yearly subscription, in that case they will not pay anything for a specific trip. So the cost will be equal to the cost which is in the database if people do not have a general abonnement. And if they happen to have a general abonnement, this quantity here will be 0. As it is multiplied by SMCO, then the SM cost variable will be equal to 0 for people owning a general abonnement. Same logic for train cost. We are also redefining the availability condition for car and train, which are two alternatives which exist and are involved in the reveal preference data. But here we consider it only if they correspond to a stated preference entry in the file. Finally, I scale the cost and time variable to have a better numerical property of the model. Now that I have defined the parameters and the variables, I'm now ready to specify the utility functions. I have three alternatives, and for each of them, the utility function consists in the constants plus a term associated with travel time, which is the parameter multiplied by the variable, and a term associated with cost, also a parameter multiplied by the variable. Now I need to associate these functions with a specific numbering of the alternatives, which is the one that is assumed in the data file. To do that, I create what is called a Python dictionary, which is composed of a list of two things, a key, which in this case is the number of the alternative, and the expression of the utility. So here, alternative 1 will be associated with the utility function v1, alternative 2 with utility function v2, and so on. Now I'm doing the same for the availability conditions. And it's the same idea. I define another dictionary called AV here, and for each alternative, I associate with it the condition that defines the availability of the alternative. In this case, it's just the name of a variable, which is either available directly in the file or that has been added above. And now to finish the model specification, I need to explain what is the contribution of each observation in the sample to the log likelihood function. In this case, we will be considering a logit model. So the log probability is given by a model called log logit, which is available in the module models of Biogeme that we have imported above. And that takes three arguments: the dictionary of utility function, capital V, the dictionary of availability condition, AV, that you have defined just above, and here the expression that characterizes the choice, the observed choice, which typically is the name of the variable in the data file where the choice has been recorded. Now we are ready to invoke Biogeme to estimate the value of the parameter. So we need first to initialize Biogeme. To do that, we call the constructor, as it is called. Basically, we build a Biogeme object by providing the database that we have defined above and this formula logproc, which is the contribution of each observation to the log likelihood function. We also provide a name to the model. So here I call it 01 logit. This name will be used to provide names for output files later on. To run the estimation, we just need to call the function estimate of Biogeme and store the results in a variable. Here I call this variable results. Okay, the model has been estimated. So now we are ready to read the results. One way is to get the estimated parameters using this function, and it will be exported in a panda format. So this is the panda table that is the output of the estimator. We have the four parameters that we have asked Biogeme to estimate. Remember, one of them was not estimated because we have put the last parameter to one. And we have here several information. The first column is the estimated value of the parameter. The second one is the standard error calculated using the Rao-Kramer bound. And this is the t-test, which basically is the ratio between the two previous values. And we also report the p-value, which is associated with the t-test. So these two columns contain the same information presented in a different way. Now we report the same three quantities, standard errors, t-test, and p-value, but calculate it not with the Rao-Kramer bound anymore, but with the robust estimator of the variance covariance matrix of the estimator. There are more information available in the results, so we can print the results to get more information. And we obtain a list of additional information like the number of estimated parameters, the sample size, the number of data that have been excluded, the initial log likelihood value, and so on. So a lot of useful information about the estimation. Unfortunately, the formatting is not really nice. So this is why BioGeme is also producing a file called 01logit.html that contains all the estimation results in a nicer way that helps you to understand better the estimation results. Here is the file that has been produced by BioGeme. So it contains preamble with various information. So this is the name of the file, 01logit.html, and this is the name of the database. Then the estimation report contains the information that I've showed you before, but as I said, in a way which is better organized and easier to read. Next, you have a table containing the estimated parameters, which basically contain the same information as we have seen before in the notebook. So we have the value, standard error, t-test, and p-value for the Rao-Kramer estimate of the variance covariance matrix, and the same with the robust estimate of the variance covariance matrix. And finally, the report contains also the information about the correlation between coefficients. So for each pair of coefficients, you have a row in this table, and the covariance is reported, the correlation. Then the t-test to test the assumption, the hypothesis that the two coefficients are equal, and the corresponding p-value. These informations are calculated using the Rao-Kramer bound, and then they are reported again using the robust estimate of the variance covariance matrix. Finally, BioGeme reports the smallest and the largest eigenvalue of the second derivative matrix of the log likelihood function. Basically, this is very useful to detect possible misspecification of the model. And the condition number is simply the ratio between the largest and the smallest eigenvalue. If you go on the biogeme.epfl.ch webpage, you will find many more examples of models that you can estimate. There is a tag examples here, where you will find a list of models. So the first one is the one that we have just seen together. If you click on it, you have access to the Python code. And you have also the HTML containing the results, which is available here. You can also load these models directly into a Jupyter notebook. For example, there is a free Jupyter notebook accessible at Binder. It contains the model that you have seen before, and you can run it and edit it as you would do in any Jupyter notebook on your computer. The webpage contains also some documentation in terms of technical reports that you can access from the tag documentation here. One is about a short introduction to PandasBiogeme, so it contains a little bit more details than the one available in this video. The second one explains how to calculate indicators, so it's beyond the estimation of the model. One is about Monte Carlo integration, and one is about choice models with latent variables. So have fun with PandasBiogeme. I hope that you will enjoy it.